Hello, writers. Welcome to another weekly write along. I am Eva Deverell and I'm here every Sunday at 3 p.m. GMT if you'd like to join me. If this is your first time joining my write along, welcome. The way we do this is we basically do writing sprints together and I type on screen. You can see, you can watch me writing, mostly nonsense, but you know. But I do urge you to grab a pen or pencil, put some paper, or open up a new document so that we can write together and you can commit to two word sprints together at this time, right now. So the first will be a short free write session where you can warm up or you can just empty your mind of all the nonsense that's in there from your daily life. And the second one will be a bit longer. It'll be 15 minutes. And I will have a prompt if you choose to follow it. For the last couple of weeks, I've been starting with a short excerpt and just to get the juices flowing, to give us some kind of direction for the free write, if you wish it. And this week I have an excerpt from Awesome Scott Card's Characters and Viewpoint. And this is probably my favorite book on character. It's really brilliant, and I feel it's rather unusual, I think, for a really good writer to also be a good writer on writing. I don't know whether good writers just don't feel the need to write about writing, or at least not at length, maybe not for the length of a whole book. I don't know, but this is a really brilliant book on character, I feel, and I will probably be sharing more excerpts from it in future write-alongs. So let me read this out. Our self, then, is a kind of network, many threads connecting us to many different people who are always shifting. We grow within any relationship that remains close. When relationships are interrupted or fade away, the self that belonged in that relationship stays the same. Getting together with old buddies you haven't seen since school, you tend to become the same person you were when you all used to hang out together. So you may think you know a person because of frequent contact in one setting, but in fact, taciturn fellow at work may be a cut-up at the bowling alley. Your tough guy buddy may be embarrassingly sentimental with his kids. Your quiet, polite daughter or son may curse like a truck driver, note the stereotype, with friends. It is also one of the most startling and effective devices in fiction to take characters out of one setting and put them in another, where different facets of their personality come to the fore. The character himself may be surprised to realize who he becomes when circumstances change. So I think this is a really interesting exercise to have a go at. For the free write, you could completely ignore it, of course, or you could think about yourself in a really strange setting, or maybe, you know, at your high school reunion or something of that sort. Or you can just write about whatever you feel like. But we will be going for 5 minutes and I will set my timer. So let's ready, set, and get writing. as our time up. So I hope you did some warming up. you probably don't want to read what I wrote. So now let's move on to our main prompt, which is place a character in an uncharacteristic setting. So you can choose a character that you already have, or you can continue writing about yourself if that would interest you. But we're going to be writing for 15 minutes. So I will set my timer and I hope you're ready to write. 3, 2, 1, let's go. That's our 15 minutes up, unfortunately. We've come to the end of another write-along. I hope you enjoyed yourself. I hope you wrote lots and lots of cool stuff. I have no idea where the scene is going or what's going on, but I was really enjoying writing it. So I hope you will join me next Sunday for another weekly write-along. Tweet me at either Devril or leave me a comment on YouTube and let me know how many words you've got. And if you have any suggestions for the format or for readings I should do or anything of that sort, please let me know. I'm very happy to hear your feedback. So until next week, keep writing.